Here I'm asked to solve what's called a compound inequality. In reality, we have two inequalities in one. Negative 7 is less than 4x minus 3, and at the same time, 4x minus 3 is less than or equal to 9. But I'm going to work this all in one step. So first I would add 3 to all sides. That leaves us with negative 4 is less than 4x, which is less than or equal to 12. Then dividing 4 on all sides, we're left with negative 1 is less than x, less than or equal to 3. In other words, x has to be greater than negative 1 and at the same time less than or equal to 3. In other words, x has to be in between negative 1 and 3. So let's shade in all of our solutions on a number line here. There's going to be infinitely many solutions. We'll also express our answers in interval notation. Okay, since this is a strict inequality, there's no equal sign, I'm going to put an open dot at negative 1 and a closed dot at 3. X has to be greater than negative 1 at the same time less than 3. So there's all my infinite number of solutions to the original inequality expressed graphically on a number line. Now let's convert that into interval notation. Negative 1 is non-inclusive, so I'm going to use a regular parentheses for that, from negative 1 off to 3, and a square parentheses like that to indicate 3 is included in the solution set. So this is my interval notation for this set of real numbers that solves the original inequality.